Do you currently have a Facebook account? If so, you're going to want to pay attention to this, because did you know that you could be making money from that account? Today, I'm going to show you how to make money online with no website, no money, and without having a huge following. This is a proven strategy for beginners. Stick around to the very end, because I'm going to show you step for step on how to do this and how you can implement this into your business today. Hey, what's up guys? Cody here with Cyber Geek Knowledge. Today I'm going to be showing you a step-by-step tutorial of how to make money online utilizing your Facebook Marketplace and utilizing Etsy. This is a brand new method and I have never talked about this on this channel before. We're going to be tapping into a traffic source that you can tap into right now. This is an unlimited traffic source and it is 100% free. Stick with me to the very end because I am going to walk you through this step-for-step and show you exactly how many other people are succeeding while doing this. If you guys haven't already, make sure that you reach out there and hit that subscribe button, hit that notification just so that you're aware every time I come out with new content for you guys on how to make money online. Without further ado, let's wrap up and let's jump into it. All right, guys, so to start this off, you know, I do have to throw this just a full disclaimer. You know, I definitely want to throw this out there. Results definitely may vary, and I'm definitely not promising results by any means. I am not sitting here promising saying that you're going to make millions of dollars off this. I'm not saying that you're going to be able to retire and, you know, you're going to be able to settle down with your family and live off of this completely right away. You know, but this is a really easy and free way to kind of bring in a little bit of extra income. I know a lot of people that are trying to get into affiliate marketing, that are trying to buy programs, that may not have enough money to get there. This is just a great technique to get you there. I'm not saying that you can do this full time and make a living off of it. I mean, technically, yeah, you could. I know some people that do. But right away, I'm not promising anything in any way. Results definitely vary. So I just have to be clear with you guys on that up front. Now, with that being said, let's jump into this, okay? So I've broken this down into three steps. The very first step is we need to find a product. Well, basically, this is pretty much the skew of things. This is exactly what our plan is in a written down sense, in a picture, just so you can physically see it. Over here, what we're going to do is we're going to go to Etsy, or we're going to use Redbubble, something like that. For this example, we are going to be using Etsy just to make it simple, make this example really easy and really quick for you guys. But what we're going to do is you want to go to Etsy. You want to find a product, something along the lines like a candle, a wall art, anything along those lines, just a product that we can find at a decent price that we can turn around and sell at a higher price for a profit. Alright guys, so our first step is we want to go to Etsy.com. That's Etsy.com. The next step is we want to click over here and click on this little sign in button. If you don't already have an account, you can go down here and you can sign up via Google, Facebook, Apple, or you can sign up with an email address and a password. I've already got an account, so I'm going to go ahead and log in, but definitely create an account. Once you've created an account, it's going to show up here. This is going to be your home screen. In here, you're going to have, you know, related topics. You know, we're coming up on Valentine's Day, so it's got Valentine's Day here for a category. There's jewelry and accessories, clothes and shoes, home and living. There's all kinds of categories here. What you want to do for finding a product, what we want to do is we want to find a low-cost product that's popular enough that'll get enough attention that we can turn around and make a profit for. Typically, man, I tell people to think of things that are relatable at that time. So, for instance, Valentine's Day is literally right around the corner. That would be a great opportunity to do Valentine's Day. The only problem is that we're coming up close on the shipping time with Valentine's Day. So you definitely want to keep shipping, you know, relatable and keep that in mind. So another item would be something like wall art. You know, canvases are very popular right now. Candles are always a big go-to because typically you can buy a great scented candle for cheap and turn around for a good profit. So you definitely want to keep profit in mind. For this example, I'm just going to do wall art. And we're just going to see what all we can find. Just because I know they're pretty popular right now, they are going pretty quickly on a lot of other platforms. I know personally I'm a big wall art fan. I know that a lot of other people are too. So what you want to do is you just kind of want to scroll through here. And as you can see, you know, here are the prices. You know, this one's at $3.67. You know, something as simple as this, you know, it would be an easily turn around and make a profit on this. You know, so like I said, now that we've got our profit, now that we've got our product, this is $3.67, and I've seen, you know, printouts and canvases like this go for, you know, way more. Honestly, I have, as simple as this is. But now that we've got a product that we can put a profit on, we'll go ahead and jump into step two, which is going on to the marketplace. And guys, keep in mind, you know, I do want to throw this out there. You can do this for any kind of item out there. I'm just doing wall art just for this example. And what you want to do as you progress, and once you start to build multiple items and have, you know, multiple different things going on the marketplace, what I do is I go to Excel and I would just create an Excel spreadsheet where you have the link, you know, whatever this URL is right here, and then the product name next to it, and then, you know, the price, and then whatever your price is to marketplace, and so on, just so that you can stay organized. Because after a while, what you're going to see is you're going to have a bunch of listings in marketplace, and if you get bombarded with a bunch of orders and you're not organized to keep track of what the orders are, there's going to be some problems. So definitely do that when gaining some traction. But in the beginning, you know, start with one item, start with two items, and see how you do. If you don't do good with those, take the listings down, repost another listing just so you don't get lost. But for this example, we're just going to do this just because it's really simple. I've already found it, and this is so cheap. It's $3.67. You know, we can literally turn around and sell this for 10 bucks, and I guarantee it would sell. So let's go ahead and jump back in, and we're going to go to step two now. Step number two, now that we've found our product, we need to get traffic to it, right? We need to be able to get it out there and get people's eyes on it so that they end up initially wanting to buy. And what we want to do is we want to go over to Marketplace, the Facebook Marketplace or eBay, anything like that. For this example, we are going to be utilizing the Facebook Marketplace because it is free and it's extremely easy. And I know literally 90% of people have a Facebook account. So it won't be very hard, and it'll be an easy walkthrough. But like I said, we take that product from Etsy, we post it on Facebook Marketplace. Okay, guys, so what we want to do is we want to go back into the Etsy account, back into where the product was. And what we want to do is we want to go ahead and get a picture of whatever the product was that you pick. You know, for instance, I'm just going to go ahead and do a snippet of this. Typically, you know, you do want to ask them for permission. You know, it wouldn't hurt. Typically, you know, honestly, they really don't care most of the time. Typically, they don't care just because of the fact that you're going to be selling their product anyway. You're going to be bringing them more money. But, you know, if you want to be safe, definitely reach out to the owner, email them. It's definitely not a bad thing. The next step we're going to do is we want to go ahead and go to Facebook. And for those of you that don't have an account, definitely sign up. You know, you definitely need an account to do this. But what we want to go ahead and do after you've signed into Facebook, gotten into your account, logged in and everything, we're going to go ahead and scroll down. And what we want to do is we want to go into Marketplace. Once you get in the Marketplace, what you're going to do on this left-hand side is you're going to hit Create New Listing. And what you're going to do is you're going to create a, or you're going to choose a listing type. So for instance, on our example, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be doing an item for sale. So what you want to do for the very first thing is you want to go ahead and create the listing is we want to add a photo. And remember, this is that photo that we just saved and that we just took from directly from Etsy. Now you can do up to 10 photos. For this example, I just did one. In here, you can add a title to it. So what we want to do is we want to add a title pretty much close to whatever this is. I'm not going to add a long title like this, but I am going to keep it very relatively similar to what that is. So in the title, I would just paste this here, and then instead of neutral, you know, I'll just do that, you know. And then for the price, what you want to do, and for any of your items, you want to keep profit in mind. So for this, we got a lot to play with. This is literally $3.67. Now keep in mind, this is a digital download. However, I've seen digital downloads go as high as $30, $45 even. Now you don't want to be too greedy. You don't want to put it too high because then nobody's going to buy it. But for me, you know, something like this, what I would do is I would probably put it to where you're making about 10 bucks. So I would just set it to almost, I don't even know. We could even put it at 15 just to see if anybody buys. And if nobody buys, you can always lower it. So we'll start it at $15. The category, we'll call it arts and crafts because that's pretty much what it is. You know, you can kind of scroll through here. But we'll just do art supplies for now. I don't know. And then canvas. And then condition, we are going to do brand new because it's brand new. So after you've entered your title, your price, the category, the condition of it. You can scroll down here, and on the left side, there's going to be a description. Now, I've already come up with a little description. You definitely want to add a description, definitely add something a little sexier than this, a little more enticing, because this really isn't, you know, all that. But this is pretty much what it's going to look like. You know, I just put wall art is a simple and affordable way to decorate your home. Give your home a trendy look with this wall art print. You know, and down here you can add product tags just to kind of help it optimize if you'd like. And then availability list as a single item. And then whenever you're ready to, you can actually go ahead and publish this. Okay, so now that we've found our product, now that we've got our traffic, now step number three is fulfilling the order. When somebody buys, they pay us with that money. Then we go back to Etsy or Redbubble and we purchase that item with their money and with their information. That way, when the purchase goes through, they then Etsy and Redbubble then send the customer the order. They will then fulfill the order and ship it to them, and we keep the profit. This is basically just a free way of doing drop shipping utilizing Etsy, Redbubble, and Facebook Marketplace. It is extremely simple, very, very easy for beginners to do this. This requires no money out of your own pocket, and it's nothing but 100% profit. Okay, so now you've got everything set up, and it's out there on the marketplace, and somebody decides to click on your post and buy your item. What they're going to do is they're going to message you details, and they're going to send you the money. They send you the money. They send you all of their shipping details. What you're going to do now, and this is why I say it's very important to save that URL of whatever and keep a list of whatever items that you're posting. That way it's real quick and easy. You can jump back to your list, click on the URL, go to the item, and you want to add to cart. And then once you go to add to cart, you can pay with PayPal. And once you pay with PayPal, you're going to be able to enter all the details. Now, I'm not going to do this because I don't want to buy this item in particular. But you're going to enter all of their details that they send you, their shipping details, all the information about them, everything. That way, you purchase this product, Etsy will then fulfill the order and send it to them. And then you will get whatever the profit is, whatever you marked up that item. Now you guys are officially all set to go off and start making money online. Guys, thanks so much for checking out this video. I really do appreciate it. If you guys did find some value in this, please hit that like, hit that share. Go ahead and comment below your thoughts, questions, concerns, anything at all. Just trying to get that algorithm going, get this information out to as many people as possible. If you guys do want some more one-on-one personal training, definitely check the link below. I will post my Facebook group down there. That way we can get a little more one-on-one personal training and help you fulfill your goals a little bit faster. If you guys are looking for my number one recommendation to making money online, check that link below. It will be in the description. It'll be the number one link in the description. It's definitely worth checking into. Other than that, guys, thanks so much again for watching this video, and we will see you on the next one.